Rachel Bone with We Got Nothing. We're here at Comic Con in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. How you guys enjoying the con? Yeah! We're going to be doing some guest interviews here at the con. Our first guest, some know him as the God in the DBZ universe, or as you might know him as the narrator. But we know him as Kyle Aver. Kyle Aver.
My pleasure, my pleasure.
How you been enjoying Alabama?
Good times, good times. I always love the chance to come to a convention and meet the fans. And you know, I certainly couldn't do this on my own without being in this profession. You know, being a part of these shows and involved in the community. So I'm very, very thankful to everyone to for coming out.
First question off the bat. How did you get started in the voice acting industry?
Well, a lot of people come from the stage or on camera. I came from radio because I was way too shy and I have always struggled with memorizing lines. Voice actors always have their script. They never have to memorize. It's always sitting there in a music stand. So I actually kind of conquered the shy part of me by working in radio for over 13 years. And halfway through that, back in 2000, I heard about auditions at Funimation and tried out on Dragon Ball Z, a show I was a fan of for at least 5 years whenever it started airing in America. I used to go around the house imitating the narrator. And, whoa! You know, fast forward, I'm playing Teen Gohan, the narrator, Ox King, West Kai, PyCon, other bit parts and everything, and being a part of a show that I actually was a fan of.
See, I find that interesting because a lot of voice actors usually, whenever fans have been anime before, they work in the anime industry, so I'm actually surprised about that. What anime do you watch? Is there anything particularly like?
Nowadays, I actually haven't had time to check out much of things. My interest level in the show is based on what the fans are raving about. I mean, the show that I'm really intrigued, and I'm actually in, but I haven't seen, is Soul Eater. And I know it's like on Netflix now, and the box sets are out and everything. I voiced Masamune in there. A really cool sort of two-episode arc character. But yeah, I kind of base my interest on what are the fans into. That's how I got into Full Metal Alchemist. What's this thing called Cowboy Bebop? That's how, you know, that's one of my all-time faves. Ghost in the Shell is a lot of fun. I managed to work my way into that as well in Solid State Society, voicing Mune, who's like the lead villain on that movie. And then doing a lot of games. Most recently, Marvel vs. Capcom 3. It's
Ryu.
Yeah.
Now, did you have to listen to any of the actors who voice for Ryu, or just
no? They simply based it on an audition that I came in and gave. They asked me to come in and read. I read for Ryu as well as other characters, and then I got lucky. I got this iconic character who doesn't say a lot, but people know who he is, and that's the interesting thing about the crossover. Most anime fans are gamers, but not all gamers are anime fans. So if I say Street Fighter to the average person on the street, they're going to know what that is, most likely. If I say Naruto, Bleach, Dragon Ball Z, maybe you'll see a little twinkle in their eye. They go, oh, I think my little brother watches that or something. But I mean, it's just really cool. I mean, growing up on things like Speed Racer, Star Blazers, Battle of the Planets, then high school, Robotech, Vampire Hunter D, Akira, and then and get into the 90s and stuff with Cowboy Bebop, Full Metal Alchemist, Yu Yu Hakusho, Dragon Ball Z. And to be a part of that is just like a really, really awesome sensation. It's really hard to describe. The Japanese games tend to be done concurrently while the English version is being produced. So the only reference we have, instead of lip sync for anime and video games, it's a Japanese game, we are basically using the Japanese audio for timing. If this line says, I'm gonna get him, go, you know, attack! If that line in Japanese takes 10 seconds, then we know in English, our line that is faithful to that Japanese translation also has to be roughly 10 seconds long.
Another question, guys, for the voice of Ryu is Deadpool is, of course, added to Marvel's Capcom 3.
Yes.
And everybody knows Deadpool and Shoryuken in that game.
Yeah.
So how does that work when you saw that for the first time?
I think I first saw it as a joke from an actual Deadpool comic. I was just blown away that they had Street Fighter humor in a Marvel comic. I'm a big fan of Deadpool. I mean, more so now that they've used him to great comedic effect on Marvel vs. Capcom 3. I tried out for that character. I didn't get it, but I don't want to take anything from Nolan North, who's just been crushing it as that character. He first showed up on the Hulk vs. Wolverine special, and it's like, man, Deadpool needs his own series, honestly. Anyone who, a character who breaks the fourth wall, especially Marvel vs. Capcom 3, where his big finishing move is taking his status bar and beating his opponent with it. You can't go wrong with that. I mean, that's just amazing.
So, you tried out for Deadpool.
I did try out for Deadpool back in the day.
How did you do that voice? Like, what was your approach on that voice?
Basically, just a friendly, smarmy sort of a Kamina voice. Really, I did Kamina and Gurren Lagann. So I just made him sort of, yeah, I know what's going on. Yeah, I'm sort of a smart aleck guy and that, this, that, and the other. I tried out for Gambit. These were characters that I originally tried out for either the games like Marvel Ultimate Alliance or Wolverine and the X-Men. Now, being from Louisiana, I thought it was a shoe-in. You know, being Kyle Hebert from Louisiana, why not play a Cajon? But I guess it was not meant to be. But that's okay.
What are you working on right now?
Right now, the only recurring thing I have is Bleach. Outside of that, I work more in games than in anime. I'm very thankful for that because games pay more than anime. They have bigger budgets, and there's just a lot of, despite the crappy economy, you know, gamers are spending money, continue to spend money, whether it's downloadable games or console games, and PC, of course, you know, StarCraft, Warcraft, those sales aren't hurting at all. So I continue to audition and audition and audition, and once in a while I get lucky.
Do we have any questions for Kyle Hebert? If anyone wants to ask any questions,
yes, you.
Do I regret voicing Aizen?
No. Being a voice actor means you only work when they call you. So if they weren't calling me to voice Aizen, that would be less money I would be making. So from a very raw standpoint, no, I would miss that work. From a creative standpoint, I get to play a character obviously as far away from me as possible. I mean, what actor doesn't want to play a villain? And it's just a chance to use a voice that I don't normally get to use. I'm usually,
there's a big bulky voice that's deep down here.
Or maybe some smarmy teenage voice like Kiba, Naruto. But Aizen's very sultry and smooth and like, oh baby, what are you wearing? You know? Except he's evil. So that's just a chance to flex and try something different. And
can I have you do that as my voicemail?
Sure, why not? That'll be $4.95. A minute.
Yeah. Any other questions? Yes.
I hate to be this guy, but can you please do some Dragon Ball Z voices?
From Dragon Ball Z, I usually get this. People like to hear the narrator.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z, Kyle goes Super Saiyan at Comic-Con.
I was always hoping the narrator would get his own action figure. You know, maybe a microphone and a blister pack. A big question mark in there. It's like, what does he look like? I don't know. And the great thing about the narrator on Dragon Ball Z is he's not an animated character, so there's no lip sync. So, and he probably has the most lines. I like that, because he starts and ends every episode for 291 episodes. So I could say DBC has probably netted me the most money over the course of my old voice acting career, between the show and the games.
One more question. Yeah.
Out of all the characters you auditioned for and didn't get the role, which one did you want the most that you didn't get?
I would have loved Deadpool. I would have loved Gambit. I would have loved anything I ever try out for, to be honest. But that's not realistic. Actors try out for things and they may get 1 out of 50, 1 out of 75. I mean, the ratio is ludicrous. And it makes you start to question, it's like, do I just suck? But no, it's a numbers game. There's so many people of varying levels of experience and talent and that are all reading for it. And I'm always hopeful. I do the best I can in that small little thing. I do most of my auditions from home for games. For anime, I have to kind of physically go in still. But for commercials and video game stuff, I do it from home. And then I send the MP3 off to my agent or whoever's casting. And sometimes I get lucky. So we'll see what happens.
Thank you so much for coming on.
Yay! Thank you. Absolutely.
You guys are awesome.